Good morning, children, and welcome again for this class. A Gorilla in the Guest Room by Gerard Birrell, and Critical Appreciation today we are going to read. Okay, Critical Appreciation. I had forgot to tell you in the previous video that Gerard Birrell was born in India actually. Okay. Though he was not an Indian, Britishers were here, so his parents were mixed British and Irish. Okay, however, so Gerald was born in India, Jamshedpur. Okay, and then after going back to England, his zoo. It is named as Jersey. Okay, in Jersey he has the zoo where he tried to preserve the endangered species. Now his progeny is looking after. He was born on 7th of January 1925, and he died in the year 1995, same month, January, but 30th of January 1995 he died, of course, before your birth. Okay, children, so today we will try to analyze the story, Critical Appreciation, or analysis of the story. As usual, we'll analyze its title, genre of the story, then what style the author has used in this story, so what style is used in this particular story, and then we will see the theme and the message of the story today. Okay, so welcome once again, we will go ahead. Children, we read the critical analysis. I have written here the same thing you can write, and I'll try to send it through PDF also, or you can write like this only. So, Gorilla in the Guest Room by Gerald Birrell, critical analysis. Introduction, you should write like this. A Gorilla in the Guest Room depicts the relationship between a gorilla and his master, Mr. Birrell. Most of Gerald Birrell's stories are semi-autobiographical, based on his real life experiences, okay, with animals. So is this story, A Gorilla in the Guest Room. So it is a semi-autobiographical story. Now, the title. We analyze the title. In fact, the title is very apt or fitting for this particular story, as Mr. Birrell had to house Npongo in his own guest room till a proper dwelling place was ready in the zoo at Jersey. Secondly, it is startling, suggestive title. So it evokes curiosity in the reader to find out the reason of keeping the gorilla in the guest room instead of in a zoo or in forest. You understand, isn't it, children? So naturally, a curiosity comes in our hearts. Why? A gorilla in the guest room. So you will feel like reading to find out the reason. Second one, style and language of this particular story is, it is narrated by Birrell in a lucid, simple and direct way. He writes about acquiring the baby male gorilla Npongo and female baby gorilla later on, that is Nandi, in an interesting manner, that they appear very much like human beings. His concern for the total well-being of N. Pongo is very catchy, so attractive. The coming together of N. Pongo and Nandi in the same enclosure is described romantically. The comparison between both the illness and treatment, etc., is very lively and realistic. So the comparison between both, who? N. Pongo and Nandi, and the illness and how he was treated, all this is very lively and realistic. So number three genera, or the form of the story, is factual narrative. Okay, for the story develops in the chronological sequence. It is narrated with all the factual information necessary for the telling of the story. It has a well-knit plot, this story. So themes or the message of this story, I have gathered at least, collected at least five, indicated at least five. If you have got more, you can write, children. Okay. Number one, a zoo should not be mere show place of animals, but should contribute essentially towards the conservation of wildlife. So this is the message Durrell wants to give. Second theme or the message is, we should be aware of the animals' needs and urges. They prefer the company of their own species. Okay, though they are happy with the human beings, and yet their own species they prefer to live with. Third, taking care and treatment of the animal on time is of vital importance, as they are unable to do it themselves. So animals are not able to treat themselves, so naturally it is the duty of the caretakers that you treat them on time. Number four message, fourth message or the fourth theme of this story can be, human beings should show concerns for the animals and give them their natural habitat. So instead of keeping in the guest room, however mother insisted, he was given a natural habitat, isn't it? So that he could play, jump on the tree and etc., isn't it? So that there is wildlife conservation and wildlife is conserved. Number five, cruelty of humans in dealing with animals is to be avoided. And how? By mentioning, he gives this idea through the scar in Nandi's skull given by the man who caught her. So through this particular instance, he wants to convey the message that we should not be cruel. Okay, the setting of the story. The story setting is in Jersey, a state in the USA, where the author's world famous sanctuary, which is named as Durrell Wildlife Park, shelters the rare but most endangered species. So we know where Jersey is. It is in USA. So though Gerald Durrell was born in India, later on he shifted himself to USA, where he established a very good zoo to provide animals their natural habitat and then provide them, especially to conserve the endangered species. So children, this much is sufficient. This one you can write as it is, and your critical analysis will be ready in your copy. I want all of you to write it, so that when exam nears, comes near, not only in class 11th, I am talking about class 12th as well, you can just go through and then you will be ready for the exam. Many of you have got good language and yet you are not scoring proper marks only because you take it for granted that you know everything and you don't write the things we are telling, notes. If you don't write the notes, you will not be able to revise within short period. So children, bye, God bless you.